Jared Kushner, a famed fail son, is here to tell the African American community what they need to do to succeed, even though I don't think literally anyone has asked for his input. So here he is yesterday talking about success and what you need to do to get it.
And again, one thing we've seen in a lot of the black community, which is mostly Democrat, is that President Trump's policies are the policies that can help people break out of the problems that they're complaining about. But he can't want them to be successful more than they want to be successful.
You get what he's saying there? You get what the implication of that?
Well, absolutely. You know, these lazy black folks don't want to do anything else but sit around on their butts and expect someone to give them something because they don't actually want success. So what he's seen in this black community is that what does Jared Kushner do in the black community? What black communities has he visited? Which community leaders has he discussed the issues with, or has he spoken at them the way he just did again now? What are some of those policies that the Trump administration has been tossing around that black folks just reject? By the way, black folks, this is just general broad based and just talking about black people in the country. What about your black Republicans? Are they the ones that are listening to the things that Trump is gonna do for black America? And how do you connect just a bunch of people? Just because they're all black, suddenly they all just, we have weekly meetings where we go, this is what we're doing this week, black people. Black people, we're gonna not listen to
I think it's a Zoom.
Yeah,
it's a big nowadays Zoom.
It's a Zoom. Where are the black folks meeting to make this one broad sweeping answer of how we want to reject success? Or we want to reject any way to actually go about success. Because, you know, black folks have this memo we put out every week. I got mine. It's just, you know, I have to hide it from you guys. But I got this one memo from the main black guy. And he told me, hey, you guys, let's stay away from that success thing. It doesn't work well for us. We'd rather just sit on the sidelines in this country that we've participated in our entire existence, and then just not take part in it. We don't want that. How about the successful black people? You know, you just complained about them a few months ago, the LeBron Jameses that are actually doing something and trying to change the way we approach education and our election systems in this country. LeBron James is doing that. Is he not a successful black person? He doesn't agree with you. So is he not successful anymore? Which one is it? Or you want to continue to push this narrative and this stereotype that black folks, number one, aren't successful, which is BS. And then the ones that are successful only did it because they went the right way that you believe in.
Yeah.
It's not even, there's no dog whistles anymore. Those have been tossed out when Trump first went down the damn escalator. So just speak directly to your racists and then dog out the actual targets of the people that you want to continue to keep down.
Jared, you are acting, I respect you. You're acting as if the recipe for success is complicated. It's not, it's basically like Sprite. It's just lemon and lime and presumably a glass. There's two ingredients to success, and Jared Kushner is merciful. He already gave you one. You have to want to be successful. I'm a very nice guy, and I probably look a little bit like him, so I'll give you the other one. You have to be handed hundreds of millions of dollars by your family. That's all it takes, is wanting to be successful and being handed hundreds of millions of dollars so that you can fail over and over and over for your whole life and it never actually catches up to you. It's really the Donald Trump school of success. And now you have all of the ingredients. Being lectured to by Jared Kushner about what it takes to be a success is the richest thing in the world other than the family that gave him everything he has, basically. As Don Bayer said, born on third base, thinks he hit a triple, that should be on his tombstone someday. Not Don Bayer's, on Jared Kushner's. Yeah, just handed money, handed opportunities, handed skyscrapers, and eventually handed positions in the White House by a guy even less well equipped and experienced to actually do something about those things. So anyway, Jared Kushner, like no one was asking. It's the definition of the absolutely nobody meme from Jared Kushner, yeah, right there. You want a little bit more? You want a little bit more, Jared Kushner?
Yeah, sure.
Here he is talking about George Floyd and the protests that have been going on throughout this year.
So look, there's been a lot of discussion about the issues that were needed in the black community for the last years, but particularly it intensified after the George Floyd situation. And you know, you saw a lot of people who were just virtue signaling. They'd go on Instagram and cry, or they would, you know, put a slogan on their jersey or write something on a basketball court. And quite frankly, that was doing more to polarize the country than it was to bring people forward.
Jer, I've been waiting to find out what the actual effect of all of this social conversation and movement has been. And I've been waiting to find out from Jared Kushner whether it was a good thing for Black Americans or not. And apparently it wasn't.
So apparently it wasn't. It was just a bunch of virtue signal on Instagram and then on your jerseys and on basketball courts. I remember when people were out in the streets protesting the things that were going on and protesting all the police murders because of what happened with George Floyd. And that was finally like a rallying cry for more than just Black folks to come forward and be disgusted with the way we've always been treating people in this country. So I remember when that happened and they said, how dare these thugs run out in the streets and start burning their communities and flipping police cars and attacking law enforcement. Which one is it? Are they sitting on Instagram virtue signaling or are they in the streets trying to protest what's been going on? Which one is it? No matter what we do, it is a problem. Mm-hmm. That's what the answer is. If you stay quiet, why are you staying so quiet? It must not be a problem. If you get loud, why are you so loud? You're so aggressive. This is what's wrong with your community. If you go on the internet and say, hey, we're gonna organize and do this. Hey, why are you just on the internet sitting around doing nothing? No matter what you do, you're wrong. That's where the power structure comes in. If you're sitting in a position of power like this guy is, by absolutely no work of your own by getting there, you're sitting in your position of power, you can dole out and tell people what they've done wrong and what they did right. And oh, maybe you shouldn't have done it this way. Maybe you shouldn't have that way. Maybe I'll listen to you if you decide to come and kiss my feet and then say that you're in support of me and my father-in-law, then maybe I'll listen to you and then do nothing about it. We know how this whole thing works. And just, sorry, I got a text from the lead Black guy. He told me to shh about the emails.
Who is he? Give us a clue, come on.
He told me to keep it quiet because I've already said too much.
Okay. I don't want to get you muted on the next Zoom. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.